Hi, this is Deep Dark Yoga and I'm April Fox. We're gonna listen to some doom metal, some low, heavy, deep tunes, do some fairly gentle, fairly chill kind of yoga together, some stretches, some holds. We're gonna do a lot of twisting today, which tends to stimulate the digestive system. It's also really good for your lower back to kind of ease around the hips. So it should feel pretty delicious if you just ate a large burrito or you are growing a human inside of you. Please take it easy and listen to your body. Just be good to yourself, always. Always listen to your body and be good to yourself, which is part of what we're trying to do here, part of what we're building. If you want to do this live with us, we do it on Thursdays, 6 p.m. Pacific, West Coast time. Check out where that is, where you're in the world. And if you want to sign up, if you want to get more info, it's down below. And while you're down there, make sure to hit like and subscribe so that you can get more of our videos.
Welcome.
I like to sit on something comfy starting practice, so feel free to grab a pillow or anything that feels good for you to sit on. And you don't have to sit like I am, just sit in a way that makes sense for your body. I've been reading a really good book on getting to know people and like having really truly deep human connection. Of course, this is a fascinating subject for me as a yoga teacher and being as invested as I am in the ideas of community and connection. And there is something really wonderful, there's many wonderful things about having community and having people who are in your corner and by your side, and the close, intimate relationships we have that are resources and really big tools for us. And one of the themes in community and connection and relationship is this idea of accompaniment. Like how a pianist would accompany a singer and help, you know, showcase and help to facilitate the singer presenting their work. Or, you know, in a play, you have, or in a musical, you have the musicians accompany the thing. And not to say that at some point you musicians aren't the highlight. Anyway, I will digress. But this idea that we have this capacity to support, uplift, and stimulate the growth of those around us. And as a teacher, this is a really fascinating subject because, you know, I could very well just say, this is the pose, do the pose, or in other things I might teach, you know, you want to give people the answers. But that doesn't really facilitate a rich understanding. A rich understanding comes from probing and, you know, like creating different types of investigative exercises, which is why a lot of times I'll say, hey, like move your arm here and see what happens if you turn it this way, just because that's what's most interesting, I think, about this practice, is to be very into that idea of playing around, of experimenting, and of letting that be kind of a way for you to learn something, to teach something to yourself. And we invest in the depth of relationships when we're able to kind of play and to give back and forth with this idea of an accompaniment, where sometimes, like, you know, you lean on me, sometimes I lean on you, you know, we have different levels of where we need to go with that and what needs to be highlighted. And so to always be open to, you know, sometimes it's this way, sometimes it's that way, but to be willing to experiment, to play. And one of the cool things about play is that we are more alive in those moments. We're more open to stimulation. We're more open to responsiveness to things when we are at play, when we're in a moment where we're finding joy, when we're finding spontaneity, when we are rolling in our back in the carpet as dog does. Yes, I think my dogs are really good at connecting, and I'm still working out how to be connected to them. Let's start with some face brushing. Take your index finger and your thumb together and take the squishy spot at the bottom of your thumb and bring that into the center of your forehead and brush outwards towards your temples a few times. And then going from the sides of your nose out to your temples along your cheekbones. Hey, Rachel. And temples down to your chin, along your jawline, tracing the bottom edge of your face. And the sides of your nose, down to your laugh lines, down through your laugh lines to your chin. And then bringing your fingertips underneath and behind your ears, massaging back there, finding a lift through the back of your neck, softening, lifting, letting yourself grow a little bit taller. Resting your hands down in your lap, letting the face relax, feeling that clearing off that the brushing did. Maybe rolling your shoulders down and back. And take some deep breaths, offering yourself this willingness, this permission to play, to experiment. Investigating throughout this practice. And then taking a nice deep breath in through your nose. Big exhale through the mouth. Again, like that. For three ohms. A little bit softer, more like so, just bringing your knees into your chest. And then bringing your palms onto your knees and rolling your knees around in circles so you feel some rocking from hip to hip. Opposite direction, circling the other way. And coming in back to the center, keep holding on to your right leg, let the left leg drop to the floor or maybe extend out in front of you. And then make some circles around your right foot so you're moving your ankle bones and your foot bones around and take those circles in both directions. Soften your foot, let the thigh become a little heavier. Let out an exhale. And then start to pull the right knee over towards the left. We'll take the right arm out to the right, dropping the right knee as far over as feels good to you. Take a moment to pet your pet if they happen to be nearby. Find softness around your belly. Give yourself another two exhales to soften. Hey, Robin Mel. After that second exhale, come back to the back. Go ahead and set your right foot down. Tuck the left knee in. And you can leave the right foot there. Let the leg extend out longer. We'll move the left toes around in circles. Maybe feeling a little snap, crackle, and pop. And then take the circle in the opposite direction. And let your foot relax, let your leg relax. Try to keep the breath steady. Letting the action be there in the breath and letting the body instead find more softness.
Maybe you feel the breath move the body. And then taking the knee over to the right side, so we'll use the right hand to guide it. Take the left arm out to the left. Maybe you play around with, do I want the palm to face down? Do I want the palm to face up? How does that feel around my shoulder, around my heart? What works a little better at this moment? Finding that softness in your center that allows the twist to rotate a little more fully. Give yourself over to the next exhale. And then coming back to your back, we'll put the left foot down and then bring the right ankle onto the left knee. Take your right arm between your legs and hug your left thigh. If you can, try flexing your feet. So you're almost kind of pressing the left foot forward, making things a little bit more energetic. If this is a lot, just relax the feet. But if you can, put a little bit more effort into the legs while still finding that softness in your breath. One more breath out. Then you'll leave the right ankle at the left knee, but put the left foot down on the floor, and then you're going to tilt the legs over towards the left, finding a twist. If you want this to be a little more gentle and support yourself, you bring your hands to your belly, to your hip. If you're feeling a little more frisky, maybe you open the arms wide. And again, find that softness through your belly. One more breath out. Then you'll come back to the center. You're gonna slide the right leg all the way over. So now you're cross knee on knee. Scoot your hips a little bit over towards the right and then let the legs go over towards the left. I like to stop where my foot catches me so it's not a really, really deep twist, especially earlier in the practice. But if you wanna go further, go for it. Find that softness in your center. And then you're just gonna unwind the right leg and continue to let the knees drop over towards the left. And maybe there's something else you can let go of, something that you can soften a little more. Maybe it's easier to breathe without your limbs twisted up quite so strangely. Let out another exhale and return yourself back to the center, probably having to wiggle your hips a little bit to find that neutral space. Left ankle comes up to the right knee and then reach around and grab onto your right thigh. If you're feeling up to it, the feet are flexed, the legs are more active. If that feels a little too stimulating or hard to breathe or you can't stop clenching your face muscles, then just let those feet relax. Not that important. See if you can keep this dynamic energy to your legs while leaving a soft, a quality of ease in your breath, in your face. One more breath out. And leaving the left ankle at the knee as you drop the right foot down, and we'll take the shape and just drop it over towards the right side. It's okay if your knee ends up facing down a little bit more. As long as it's okay with your body though, try to have the knee facing up a little bit more. Yes, it's super deep into that hip, but nobody died yet is my thing I say to like HIIT classes and stuff, but don't worry, we won't do like push-ups and nonsense, so probably we'll all be fine. Probably, I don't know. Finding the breath. Let
letting those exhales soften you. And then bringing the legs back up so that you can slide that left leg over so that now the thighs are fully crossed. Do a little scooch of your hips over to the left, and then the legs drop over towards the right. You might open your arms. You might leave the arms closer into the body to make this just a little more gentle. Keep exploring, what can I let go of? Where am I holding tension that I don't need to? Where's that spot that no matter how many times I tell it to relax, it seems to keep tensing up? Which is a universal response. It's okay that that happens. It's part of the work. One more breath out. And you're just gonna unwrap that leg, let both knees drop down, and find that ease creeping into the body as we no longer have quite so many knots tied in ourselves. One more breath out. And then coming back to the center, shifting hips back to the center. And we're just gonna roll ourselves over. So you're gonna go right onto your belly. Hold on. Do you need to eat that right there? Of course you don't. And we're gonna take an open twist to the heart. So you're gonna take your left hand out to the left, palm facing down. My right hand is right here by my shoulder, kind of like I'm in cobra. And then look to the right, drop your head down and roll the right leg back and away from the floor. So we're feeling that opening to the left side of the chest. Let out another exhale. And then roll back to your belly and we'll switch sides. Now the left arm goes out, or the right arm goes out to the right, left hand pulls in by the shoulder. Make sure to rest your head as you come into this so that you find a place that is soft at the neck. Feel this opening around the heart. As you exhale, returning to your belly and coming up to your forearms. So we're going to bring the elbows just about underneath the shoulders so that they're stacked. You shouldn't feel like there is too much effort in being held up here. But we do want to have a little bit of force down into the forearms to support us, a little bit of lift. And then start to make some circles in your head, leaving the shoulders steady. And after a few circles around in one direction, go ahead and change that direction of the circles. Relaxing the circles, take your gaze up. Make sure to pull both shoulders back. Maybe you even lift the belly muscles a little here, a little more stimulating to keep the body steady. As you look over towards the left side without the shoulders following you. And look over towards the right side and mind that you keep the body engaged here so we can let the head move freely. Then taking the gaze forward again, go ahead and lower down to your belly, rest your head on your hand, shift your hips back and forth a few times. And then come back to a child's pose. And bring both hands over towards the left side of your mat, resting your head down, feeling a little extra stretch along the right side of your body. Maybe you even find yourself leaning the hips over to the right a bit. One more exhale. And then switching to the other side, hands go over towards the right side of the mat.
reaching into the left hand, maybe even leaning the hips over towards the left more to find more space along that side. Letting the breath out. And then returning to the center, letting the arms drop, the forehead drop. And curling through a cat pose, draw yourself up through the cat to your table pose. And then drop back, curling yourself through the cat back to child's pose. Exhale. Inhale, curl through the cat to a table pose. Relax the spine. Curling, exhale, back through the cat to child's pose. And take that just a few more times. There's a subtlety in arriving to that table pose. There's a little bit more heat, perhaps, in the belly as we curl through the cat to change shapes. Next time you arrive in your table pose, hang out there. And we'll slide the right hand just behind the left hand, coming down to rest on the shoulder. I like coming up to fingertips. You might not. You might like to crawl the hand out or slide it behind your back or do whatever kind of fancy business that you can breathe through that you enjoy. If you would like to, and maybe you wouldn't, so that's okay, maybe you would kick your left foot out in the direction of your right hand. It's sometimes a little more stimulating, not so fun on the neck, so don't do it if it doesn't feel good. Let out one more exhale. Then make sure that left hand is planted steady on the floor in front of your face as you unwind the right arm and pull the left knee back in if you sent it out. We'll send the left hand now just behind the right hand. Maybe you come to fingertips or figure out something else that you'd like to do with that right arm. Maybe you kick the right hand, right foot out towards the left hand. One more exhale. Then pulling your right knee back in. Make sure the left hand is planted, or right hand is planted in front of your face. I'm wearing the left arm. Okay, so we all found our way out of there. We're going to take the hands a little bit further forward. Curl your toes under and press back to a downward facing dog. We're going to come up to a forward fold in a moment. So if you want to get off your hands, just walk your feet and your hands closer together and rest in a fold. And we'll all find our way there now, walking the feet up, the hands back, maybe bending the knees quite a bit, maybe bringing hands up higher on the legs. Taking a deep exhale. Standing yourself up, lifting the arms, and then bringing them down into your heart. And we'll face you. We're going to take your right leg and bring it back behind your left. Okay, right leg back behind the left. Basic motor function here. And then you're going to hold onto your right wrist and create a side bend. And what I often notice is that this hip kind of slides back. And instead, we want to take that hip forward, maybe even take that right arm a little bit further forward. So we're really opening up from the area I call the side pants, up through the outside of your armpit. Maybe you even push a little bit more into that back foot. And then release the side bend, take your hands down. Maybe you bring your hands to your shins or to the floor. You could grab blocks or something to make your arms a little bit longer. If you would like more sensation, push into your big toes
If you want less sensation, don't do that. If you want more sensation still, you might walk your hands over towards the left side. Let out another exhale. Walk yourself back to the front if you had walked to the side. And you're going to leave the legs crossed as you stand up, which some days is like, holy hell, whose legs are these? And some days you're like, why did she say that might be difficult? I don't know which it is. That one was easy, which tells me that this side is going to be the doozy. Let's hold on to the left wrist. I'm in this big, expansive side space, knowing that my hip tends to go back, which tends to create more back bend, which inhibits my side bend extension, so I want the hip to go forward. And then I go, wee, wow, look at all that space between my ribs. Feeling even that side of my vertebrae get more space. Ooh, one more exhale. Then releasing the side bend, come forward, fold to whatever degree feels reasonable to you. And find a space that you can breathe through where you're not feeling like, oh shit, I have to like touch my feet or I'm a bad yogi. No, we breathe and then we touch whatever we touch. Well, this is that practice. Oh, maybe you walk your hands over to the right. It's a practice of play, of experimenting. That's our practice of connection, is finding that willingness to give and take. And some days you're really driving the body, some days we're just accompanying this meat sack as we wander through space, walk back to the center, and then stand up. Oh, wow, didn't fall over twice. There we go. Uncross things, shake them out. Let's take the legs really wide here. And then come down into a forward fold and just soften yourself in. Maybe you bend your knees, you shake yourself out a bit. Hi, sir. What are you looking for? Your squirrel, your raccoon, your little potted plant guy? Okay. We're hitting all the bases today. And then walk your hands over towards one of your legs and pull yourself in just a little bit closer. If you use the opposite arm to pull that leg, how much does that change the upper back sensations? And then walk your hands over towards the other side, pulling with the opposite arm. One more exhale. Then come back to the center and lift yourself up to standing. We're gonna turn the toes until we find ourselves opening towards warrior two. And there is a subtle amount of twisting happening here. We wanna twist the hips this way, the thigh that way, and then the ribs more open. So my hips there, ribs here, knee here, things are a little twisted. And I'm going to turn my heart to face towards the right hand as I lift up. Peaceful warrior, making an offering of my heart upwards. One more breath in. And then side angle. And then noticing I have that tendency for my hip to go back. Can I instead bring the hip forward and then feel more space along that side body? This one's gonna get a little bit spicy. We're gonna take that left hand and bring it all the way down to the floor. You can bring your left knee to the floor if you want, or just pivot onto your toes. And then look over towards the right. Maybe you extend your right arm up in the air. If this is going well and you have more layers you can add on, try lifting your inner thighs, bending the right arm a bit to open the shoulder more, and then find softness in your belly as you exhale. Give it one more exhale. And then walk the hands around to the left, coming back to your wide-legged forward fold. Stand yourself up. And then we turn toes over to the left. As you bend into the left leg, you've got hips that go over a little bit, and then a rib cage twists open. at this side. Looking out over the left fingertips. And turn your heart towards those left fingertips and lift the heart up to those fingertips as you extend them towards the sky. One more big breath in. And side angle as you exhale. Soften your belly back. Maybe take the arm forward a little more so we're really long in that spine. In order to have good twists, we need to make lots of space through the back. Longer, more open, more fluffy in texture rather than dense in texture. And we'll make it just that little bit more spicy, taking that low twist lunge. So taking the right hand down, we'll come to the right toes, maybe to the right knee if you feel like that would serve you more. We'll try to take the left arm up in the air. As I bend the elbow, I'm able to open my shoulder more. My shoulder feels just a little bit less crunchy and jagged and stuck. Maybe you lift the inner thighs more and feel yourself able to twist deeper, hopefully still breathing. Softening the exhales. And then both hands down, walk it out to that wide-legged forward fold. Stand yourself all the way up. Bring your feet in underneath you. Shake and wiggle the appropriate things. How are we doing? Good. And then with feet about hip width, maybe even just a touch wider to give yourself some extra space, we'll take an inhale and lift up. On your exhale, fold forward. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Bring hands down to the floor or to shins. Then you'll bend the left leg more than the right leg and take the right arm open into a twist. It doesn't need to go to 6 o'clock. Mine actually doesn't look like it's 6 o'clock to me, but in the monitor I do. I don't know. So maybe you know that you don't even need to shoot for 6 o'clock because it's objects and something are different than they appear, yada yada. And then switch sides. What I'm saying is if it's here, and that feels like the most you can do is fine. One more exhale. And both hands down, gently stand yourself up. And now you're gonna cross your left leg in front of your right, bend into your knees and sit your hips back. We're gonna take the arms open. So maybe we've got eagle legs and then like what we would think of as eagle arms, like we're gonna go flying, maybe you lift the front toes up. And then unwind things, set your feet down, cross the other leg in front, and make sure as you bend into your knees that you're pushing back in your hips. We don't want the knees to go forward. I'm gonna push back, open your arms like wings, maybe you lift the front toes. Let out an exhale. Unwind yourself, put your feet where they belong. Cross one arm on top. You can give yourself a hug. Let your feathers spread out or wrap your feathers together. One more exhale. And then unwind the twist of your arms. You've got feathers wrapped up, feathers free, feathers giving you a hug. You choose what seems like it's working for you, like you can breathe through it, like you're not mad about it. Let the breath out. And then unwind your arms. We're gonna do the arms one more time. We're gonna do the sitting back in the legs one more time. If crossing the legs over is making things just way too wild and balanced for you and you feel like you're gonna fall over, then you just leave the feet really close together and sit back like so. So legs crossing, we'll let that be optional on this one. So you're gonna take one leg and cross it over. The opposite arm is gonna cross over, or you don't cross one leg over. Okay? And then we're gonna come down and we're gonna try to bring those elbows, whether I'm hugging my shoulders or whatever I'm doing, drawing my elbows as close as I can get them down towards my knee. Maybe I take my elbows and I bring them to the outside And then top leg. Woo. And then unwind.
Set things down, shake it out. I feel really lopsided, so we have to do the other side. You're gonna cross the other leg over. Cross the other arm over. Find where you want your feathers to go. And bend into your knees, sit your hips back. And start bringing your elbows down close towards the knees. This is apparently my difficult balance side today. Maybe elbows come down on the opposite side of the knees. Wow. Is very twisted in on myself. Let the breath out. And then unwind. I'm going to take just a gentle, like the gentle cycle washing machine twist here. Mild agitation for delicate fabrics. My partner did laundry at my place. He's like, God, now I know why all of your stuff is always hanging up in your apartment. Your dryer sucks. I'm like, no, my stuff's all hanging up because it's all lace and spandex. I don't put it in the dryer. Anyway, warrior one. Right foot forward, left foot back. Let's lift arms up here. Trying with whatever degree is reasonable to try to twist the hips to face forward, but they don't quite notch into directly facing forward. Move into an open twist here. Lean forward a little bit as you take the left arm forward and the right arm back, and I'm not at 6 o'clock. Make sure your right knee has it twisted inwards. And let an exhale out. And then bring your hands to your right thigh. So to your knee, to your hip. Maybe you stay here and look back over your right shoulder. Maybe you come down to your left elbow. Maybe both palms come together. We keep softening the belly and twisting the heart up in the direction of the hands, or up to the right side if we've just got hands at the thigh. Let out another exhale. And then unwind, come back up to warrior one, and then we'll bend the elbows, cactus the arms, and stretch the front of the chest. Letting the arms soften down, step the left foot forward. The right foot back. And then make sure you don't have the feet one in front of the other. It's going to make it way harder to twist those hips to face as far forward as they can. They aren't going to be able to get as far forward as they can. And take the arms up. Lifting the heart. Find that length in your spine, giving you more room to twist. And then we'll lean forward a little bit so the right arm comes forward. And the twist open to the left. I'm at like 8 o'clock, not 6 o'clock. And hands come to the thigh, or the right elbow comes down to the left thigh. Watch that the hip isn't sliding out to the left. Maybe both palms make contact. And we lift hard up to the thumbs. On the exhale, soften the belly, twisting around a softer texture. Would you rather try to twist a brick or some marshmallow fluff? Would you rather try to twist a bone or one of the toys that you already took out of the stuffing out of? Exactly. Good job. See, the squirrel's got it. One more exhale. That's why you take the stuffing out of everything. Arms up. And elbows. Let those arms continue down. And step both feet forward, bringing your feet in close together. I gotta be honest, I hate doing chair with my feet exactly together. I don't mind it if I'm doing twists like this, because then just it helps so I know when my knees are close together. So if you want your feet further apart in your chair pose, that's fine. Just make sure that that doesn't start to happen. You need to keep your legs real steady, which is harder with the feet further apart. So maybe feet are together for this one. We'll step back into a chair, not down into a chair. Back into a chair. And then take one hand to the opposite thigh and twist. Try to lift that spot behind your ears, soften your belly. Maybe you open this arm, maybe you press the back of this hand down. And then come out of it, lift up. Sit
back into that chair. We'll take the hand down, maybe you hold the knee, maybe you take the back of the hand there, and we open the other arm, push both butts back behind you. Soften your belly. Cannot lift both arms up. Now bring the hands down to the heart. We'll leave the hands at the heart this time as you sit back into a chair pose and twist over towards the right. This is one of the hard ones where the knees are going to want to follow you. Really keep those really steady. You can stay here and hover, or perhaps your elbow comes down to touch the knee, and then I can drop my hips more. Woo, babe. One more exhale. Unwind. Lift the arms up to give yourself some space. And then we'll dive right back in on ourselves, hands to hip, hands to heart. This is a heart. Hands to heart. Hips go back. Those are the words I was looking for. And then twist or twist down here. Make sure that we're dropping the hips and we're twisting all the way down here. Use that elbow. Make that heart lift a little bit. Soften the belly. One more exhale. Inhale, arms all the way up. Ooh. And then take your hands down. We're gonna bend into the knees until we're sitting down on our heels. So if this is like no thank you, you're just gonna sit down and just do some look asana, which is where you just look at what's going on around you. Or you take a seated twist, maybe though. Ooh, you try to twist. Ooh, in this little squat. Ooh-wee. Mm-hmm. Hi, you want to give it a try? I know you can sit on your hind feet like this. Can you try? You can go up. No. Because I'm not a trained monkey. Okay, and then go down to your hips. He will. He'll like sit on his hind legs and go like, please, I would like your entire meal. No. Okay, and legs open. Alright. Today I'm just going to talk to my dogs. Take your left hand to the left, reach your right arm up. Let the shoulder soften. Maybe the arm goes forward a little bit more, finding that extra space along the side of the ribs. And then letting yourself turn down in the direction of the floor. I'm gonna fold just to the inside of my leg. So it's like one slice of pizza is my leg, the slice of pizza next to it is my upper body. Let out another exhale. And walk yourself back up. We'll take that side bend over towards the right, lifting that left side long. Maybe the arm goes forward. Try to soften the space between your arm bone and your neck bones. Slowly bringing that hand down, coming into that like slice of pizza next to your leg. One more exhale. And then come up to a seat. We're going to close the legs towards each other. Pull your right knee in. If you want to cross the leg over, do it. If that doesn't feel good on your knee, then don't do it. Just leave the right foot on the right side. We'll hug the left elbow around the thigh. Lift your toes, which you'll feel will help to lift your spine up longer. And then with the heart just above the hips, don't lean back. Just twist and look back. Pull that knee in. Soften your belly. Maybe your left ribs go a little closer to your right thigh. One more breath out. Relax your twist. Relax your right leg. Pull the left one in. If you want to take it across, maybe that feels good to you. Lift those right toes. Lift the spine. Hug the leg. My left hand is back just for support. I don't want to lean back and have that hand far behind me. And One more breath out. And then relaxing your twist, unwind your legs. I'm gonna just take one back here. So I've got one shin that's kind of forward towards the front of my mat, kind of parallel to the front of my mat. And the tendency is gonna be to wanna go over the thigh because it's a little more comfortable there, but I'd like you to try to turn yourself a little bit more towards your lower leg, and it's gonna get real deep in your hips. So just go to whatever space that you can breathe into easily that doesn't feel like it's torturous. You will get more hip work if you go a little more heart towards the shin rather than heart towards your knee. One more exhale. Start to lift yourself up. This shin was back quite a bit. I'm gonna pull it up a little bit more and leave the knee down as I walk my hands back. Maybe I lift the hip, but leave the knee on the floor. You might come back to one elbow or both elbows. Opening the front of the thigh on the right side, my back leg side. One more exhale. And take both hands over to the same side so you can walk yourself up. And then you can just switch your legs around like so. I'm gonna turn around because I find it weird to face away from you as much as I can. So that leg's just back out of my way. This shin is kind of parallel to the front of the mat, and I'm sitting over on this hip. So different than pigeon, this is swan pose, more of a yin kind of thing. Yourself two more exhales. And start to lift up. Take that back leg and bring it forward. As you walk the hands back, leaving your knee down, maybe you lift your hips up here. Maybe you come back towards your elbows. Both hands over to the right side, walk yourself up, and now turn so that both knees are out and both feet are in front of you. We'll take a little shift from side to side, finding more of the sits bones. And then bring your hand down to your inner right thigh, your left hand behind you, just gently press that thigh open. Might not go far. And switch sides. To the inner thigh, not onto the knee. Bring it to the thigh bone. So you push the thigh bone open. And come back to the center. Hold the legs where it makes sense to you. Find a long spine. It doesn't have to be a perfectly straight spine, but think a long spine. There's a difference between a long spine and like I'm just hunched in, right? So a long spine, and take the long spine as far forward as you have space for, which might not be a very long, might not be a very far journey. Exhale. And then start to come down onto your back. Hold on to your shins or your feet with the knees wide. I've got my feet wide to start off with. I'll change that to feet in close, knees wide. I feel my hips going lower to the floor when I make that adjustment. Excuse you. Quiet. And then knees into your chest, giving yourself a hug. Sir. And let your arms open, perhaps to a cactus shape. We'll be very open to the heart in that twist. You're welcome to take arms open to a T or bring hands in closer by your body if that feels better. But maybe you find that big opening to the heart as there is a deep softening and relaxing inwards around the belly. Squirrel. Come here, buddy. No. Dude, hey. And then knees go over towards the other side. And soften your belly. Letting go of the control over your breath. One more exhale. And then come back to the center. Let your legs extend down on the floor. Let your hands drop down by your sides. Maybe snuggle the shoulders underneath your heart to feel a little more open and relaxed around the heart space. Sometimes bent legs would feel better, or laying on your side, or maybe you put your legs up the wall or on the couch. Find a place where you feel comfortable, where your body feels at ease, where you're able to let your breath soften, let your mind relax. Give yourself some time to play with softness, to play with rest, which is sometimes unfamiliar territory for us, but worthwhile to venture into. We'll take a couple of minutes like this before we wrap up together.
start to come back to your body. Playing with movement in your fingers and toes and taking some deeper breaths. When you're ready, roll yourself over to one side. Offer a moment of gratitude here for having the opportunity to come to practice. You're sharing this time together. And when you're ready, come up and find your own comfortable seat. Let's feel the practice, releasing one more om together. The love, the light, and the darkness that resides within each of our hearts. Thank you so much, friends. Thanks for being here. It's good to have you in Avalon. Thank you for joining. Questions.